All right, a Pennsylvania teenager has been suspended for asking a girl to the prom. Not just any girl. It was Miss America, the beauty queen, Nina Davalori. She was speaking at his school, so he decided to pop the question in person. We get more now from Al Ganoza of our Harrisburg station.
Word got around quickly. In fact, the Central York administrators also got wind of it.
Nina Davalori!
The more I thought about it, the more I was like, yeah, that would be pretty funny. That'd be great if I did that. That'd be cool. That'd be a good way to go out senior year with a bang.
Patrick says 10 minutes before the presentation, they pulled him aside and told him that such a move would be inappropriate and that he should not do it.
But at that point in time, I was already like, I was just set on doing it. I had, you know, I was looking at it as like, it was like a now or never type thing.
During a question and answer session, Patrick popped up on stage with a flower and asked Nina to the prom.
She never actually gave me a direct answer. The whole school just started cheering and stuff. I gave her the flower and she kind of just laughed or whatever.
Patrick quickly got pulled out of the auditorium and was told he was getting a 3-day in-school suspension. Now, he has no hard feelings about it, says he still loves the administration and that he understands why they punished him.
It wasn't because I asked her to prom. It was because I like directly went against what they said, you know what I mean? So that's why I was punished, which I completely respect and I completely understand their decision.
And he also apologized to the people who set up the lesson on diversity.
She was coming off with a very strong message and I did kind of overshadow it because the whole school was talking about what I did and stuff. So I do want to apologize to the people who set up the diversity event.
Patrick is going to the prom, but barring a major development, it will not be with Miss America. Still, he thanks her for being such a great sport. Al Ganoza, ABC News.